all-new four-wheel drive off-road buggy named for that formidable weapon from down under. The Boomerang.
All right, guys, welcome to the channel, and as always, thanks very much for tuning in. In today's video, we are going to be building the mighty Tamiya Boomerang. I had one of these back in the day, got it second hand. It was a dog. It still had bushings in it, and I was like, I wasn't that mechanically minded first time around. So yeah, come out again, dying to get one. So I've got this, and I've also got the Super Saber coming, which is basically the same chassis. This is kind of like the same chassis as the Hotshot, shares a lot of similar parts. I know the front and rear gearbox is a bit different. I think the chassis might be a bit different. It might be a bathtub rather than that enclosed case. So yeah, got an awesome deal from Model Sport. Buy all my Tamiya kits from there. I recommend you do the same if you want the best service available in the UK. So we're going to be pairing it up to a blue MX SR3100 Spectrum compatible receiver. Nice little receivers, get them about £12 on eBay. We're going to be pairing up with a JX4409 MG low profile servo. Nice little quick servo. These vary between about £15 to £18. They usually come from China. I have seen them for as low as £13 from China, so if you're willing to wait, you can get a pretty good deal on these. But yeah, really good servos, metal gears. Really good. Going to be pairing it up to this new ESC. Never tried this before. It's Etronox Photon SBS ESC and motor combo. It's a 4,350 kV motor with a 45 amp ESC. Nice looking little thing. Not sure what the internals are, what brand they are, but it's got a see-through bottom on it. You can just see the insides of it there. So you can see all the gubbins in it. But yeah, seems decent enough. Nice little motor. You also get a programming card. So yeah, 4,350 kV motor, should look nice. I thought it was censored, but it's not. So yeah. Yeah, programming card. So yeah, we'll have a quick look in the box and see what we get for our money. Here we go, guys. Quick look in the box. You've got bags A through to E. You do actually get some bearings. They'll probably be in for the gearbox or something maybe, but we've got plastic bushings. So we're going to replace them with a load of bearings we've got there. I think I've got them all. So we've got the bathtub chassis, the battery compartment bit, one of the front or rear gearboxes, both gearbox casings there, big front bumper, the wishbones, wheels and tyres, shocks, you only get three shocks, some of the steering components, suspension towers, shock towers, steering knuckles, yeah boys, driver, servo, saver. One mod I'm going to do to it, instead of using the coat hanger drive shaft, I'm going to go with the Hot Shot drive shaft upgrade. So you get a Hot Shot drive shaft, and you get Tony's Tamiya parts, Hot Shot drive cups. So yeah, if you just look up Boomerang Hot Shot mod drive shaft, you'll get the results. So there's a body, kind of again reminds me of that old Star Wars Sandstorm or whatever it was called, spaceship kind of design, very small body. Just going to be doing it box art white. You also get speedo cover, which really takes me back, so that's going to be going straight in the bin. You also got this as well, which looks like a bit of a chassis divide, looks like it goes in the chassis somewhere, so not too sure what that's for, but we'll sort that out. That rear wing, little wing. I think this is a new edition. It's got a 2008 stamp on it. Just a dust cover. So it'd be cool if we get all the insides neat, something to look at. There's your stickers, not many stickers. Main problem is just getting to these line up. with the front and the rear of the wing. Yeah, not many to do, but yeah, boys. So I'm going to jump straight into it and get this kit built. So let's jump into straight into step one. So here we go, guys. We're going to jump straight into step A, part one, which is starting that rear gearbox, get the motor in, pinion on, and then we're going to start the front gearbox. So easy enough. Just make sure that when you cut these little gears off, you get a bit of a knife. These bevel gears, just get a bit of a knife, take any bears off, because you'll hear it. It'll bed in after a while, but it's just nice if you get that clean cut on the gears. Just makes the gearbox feel like a little bit more nicer. But yeah, we're going to jump straight into step one and get that front gearbox, rear gearbox, sorry, built. Yeah, boys. And there we go, guys, the rear gearbox done, that beautiful blue motor in there. I've gone for the bigger tooth pinion, which is a 15 tooth. You get a 13 tooth and a 15 tooth, and I've gone, of course, for the 15 tooth. So when I run this, it is absolutely going to be stupidly quick, but I'm sure the gearbox can take it. These gearboxes are pretty bulletproof. So yeah, so that's a rear gearbox done. Now we're moving on to step 6 through to 9. Well, we'll do step 6 through to 8, which is getting the front gearbox on, and then that'll be bag A done, boys. So yeah, 6 through to 8 coming up next. Stay tuned. And there we go, boys and girls, the front and rear gearbox done. That's basically the brains of the car. A lot of it now is just fiddly, getting the arms on the suspension and all that. But that's step bag A done. Now we're moving on to bag B, which is getting the rear suspension on, the front suspension on, the front gearbox. You basically build the suspension onto the gearbox on the front and rear, and then you bolt it to the bathtub chassis. So bag B is all about getting the suspension done, so we'll do that next. And there we go, guys, front and rear gearbox done. Bit fiddly putting these plates on with the three holes in, but if you line up the big one and then just slacken it off, you're able to spin the plastic washer around so you can line all the bolts up. Yeah, front gearbox easy. A couple of issues with the rear gearbox. This little space here, and in the manual it shows it that's actually solid, but it's blank, so I've just cut an old piece of plastic into a tube. Also, when you're building the front, don't forget to add that C6 part for the shock tower to go on. It's step 3 in the manual. Don't forget to add that, or you'll be doing what I've done. And having to go all the way back and take the gearbox apart. So there's A through to B done. Now we're moving on to step C, which is getting all the radio gear in. So we'll get the radio gear in and get the rear gearbox on. Yep, so step 15 through to 18 we are doing next. Yeah, boys, flying along, flying. And there you go, guys, it's starting to feel like something, that front and rear gearbox on. Yep, gonna have to make a few adjustments to the steering. Really interesting how that steering works. It looks like it's eliminated the majority of steering bump from it. There's still a slight bit there, but Yeah. In the videos, it always looks like it's got really good suspension, but it's not. It's just the fact that it's rocking between each other. So, yeah. Still, worked for the time. So, yeah. Shocks on, front and rear gearbox on, front that prop shaft installed, that big aluminium silver prop shaft. Motor's looking dapper there, hanging out the back. So now we're just going to move on to, we've started step D, which is getting the front gearbox on. Now we're just going to get the bumper on, the anti-roll bar, get the electrics in and get the wheels on it. And then that's basically it. I will call it a day. And tomorrow we will still start afresh. So get the anti-roll bar on, the bumper on, all that good stuff. Get the electronics in. I love putting electronics in. It's probably my favourite part of the job, putting electronics in. Yeah, get the wheels on. When we come back, that'll be done. And then it'll just be a case of slamming that body on it, boys. And there we go, guys. Car is finished. Electronics in. Quite a decent job. I love putting electronics in. I see it like a form of art. It's like a piece of performance art. Kind of like how neat you can get it. Just slap it in anywhere, wherever it fits. So yeah, work with what you've got. So yeah, shocks are on. Still got to be adjusted up, but feels nice. Feels nice. I like that steering on the front. Taking a bit of the bump steer out. Still need to adjust the tracking and all that. Let's see what she sounds like. Gotta lift this up when you accelerate it because it droops so much at the front. Look at that, fingers under the wishbone. Yeah, boys, when we come back, the body will be on and this car will be finished. Oh, yeah. I enjoyed that. Didn't enjoy it as much as Grasshopper, but I still enjoyed it. It's all about the end result anyway, so when we come back, the body will be finished and this car will be done. Stay tuned. And there you go, guys. I'm gonna call that finished. I am so happy to have one of these because back in the day I had a Hornet, and at first I was like, yeah, got a radio control car, it's a proper one, it's not one of these ones with circuit boards in it, because I was into circuit boards and all that when I was a lad. So like, to have a Hornet with like servos in it, and then this come along and it was like four-wheel drive, and it felt like a proper radio control car, like four-wheel drive. I was like dying to get it. So yeah, I was robbed a bit because I looked after my Hornet. My dad used to make me something like 1 millimeter thick, like Lexan bodies in a place that he used to work. So I used to like really look after it. Yep, so to have one again, I'm over the moon. I'm very happy with how it turned out. Done a few changes to it. What I've done, I'll show you, is I put spacers in the front shock just to stop it glitching out, because like when you jump in and you're on the throttle, you don't want the suspension to do what it does. So I put about 3 millimeter spaces in the front, so that sorted that out. I looked in the book and it didn't say you needed any, but yeah, I'm very happy with that, boys. Really enjoyed that. The end result, I think it's one of Tammy's nicest looking kits, proper out there. So yeah, boys, another video, another car finished. As always, thanks for tuning in. Now on to the glory shots.